Namaste everyone. This is M. Srinivasulu, English faculty from DAV High School, RTPP Township. At first, I heartily welcome you all for the second session of Class 10th English Reading with the title called Every Success Story is Also a Story of Great Failures. Every Success Story is Also a Story of Great Failures. Before we get into the explanation part of it, let me read the lines. If you study history, you will find that all stories of success are also stories of great failures. But people don't see the failures. They only see one side of the picture and they say that person got lucky. He must have been at the right place at the right time. So let us just get into the point here. In connection to the earlier session, now we'll see the lines. If you study history, whatever the thing that is being passed is nothing but about history. And we also believe strongly that history repeats. And we generally learn lessons from the history to get into or to have a proper plan of our future. So if you study history or any persons in the history, in any kind of a field like a business or science and technology or in a political field, wherever you find, you will find that all stories of success are also stories of great failures. What now they talk about? So if you talk about all success stories, we talk about Steve Jobs, who once was a CEO of Apple company of USA. Or you can talk about someone else like Abraham Lincoln. You talk about some other one, whoever might be you are talking about. So maybe you find out his success rate or his success story. But behind that, no one was recognized as a successful person unless he had seen some sort of a great failures before he achieved that great success. So maybe, as one of the film stars say, success is not a destination, it is a journey. So however, you keep going on to have your success, but not withdraw yourself after reaching a temporary goal or after facing a great obstacle in your life, however it is. So the line essence reveals that completely, if you see anyone's life in the history, so no one story has not been paved with gold and they reached success without failure. Not like that. So they have had so many kinds of failures before they get into success. So that is what the line says. Next. But people don't see the failures. They only see one side of the picture. And they say that the person got lucky. So this is the people's attitude. Now we are talking about. But the people don't see. People, wherever they are now talking about, they would wanted to have a blame game. Generally, if you have shown Vivekananda to them also, they will try to find out the faults in one's personality. Such great people we are getting in society. So even see, if you are trying to live dignifiedly with self-respect in the life, never live on the opinions of others. You live as you have your consciousness in your mind and heart. So you follow your consciousness. What is wrong, what is not correct, or what is meaning right. So you see that and then keep following. But if you keep starting giving weightage to the people's opinion over you, you cannot lead a peaceful life. Even a great person also being insulted, bullied by these kind of people, we know very well. Even one of the experiences we can recollect in this regard, once Abraham Lincoln was elected to be a president and he was started to give his first message to the elected people in the conference. So before he gets started his message, being a president of the USA, so that time one of the gentlemen in the crowd got up and said, "Then you see my shoe here, and this shoe was mended by your father. So you remember before you speak that you are a son of a cobbler." So that are nothing but called bullies. But of course, Abraham Lincoln was given a right answer for that. and he replied the gentleman, "Thank you very much for recollecting my father. And even he taught me a proper way. Even I can mend your shoes if it is got on. I know very well. He has very very worthy workmanship." So such people we find everywhere when you walk off our life to disturb us and to distract our destination. However, people always they comment in the negative sense. Don't give weightage to the people's opinion, but you see yourself, right? So, but though people don't see the failures, whenever a person got success, and they never see only the they wanted to see only success, and they don't want to see the failures. Maybe he had number of attempts to get into success for the particular, but they never mind to comment on about his success, but they don't want to talk about his failures and struggle and even sleepless nights that he had for years of time, that they don't want all. Now they only see one side of the picture. People they even talk about no other side of the mountain is always much greener. And people wanted to see one side of their angle life, and they would not like to see the others. They won't generally they don't like to see other side of their someone's life, and they wanted to see only one side, and they start to go for blame game. This and that, and then he is a maybe lucky person, that is why he got success. I strongly believe, my dear friends, there is no luck in the world exists. It is only replica of your hard work and dedication on something will reply or represent as a success. But there is no luck place. I think it is 99.9% that 1% may be the God's will, that sometimes he wanted to see someone successful, he may try that. Anyhow, and they say that person got lucky. If any person is successful, and what the people usually they say, that this person is lucky, that is why he became successful. That means they conclude that because of the luck only he was now in that position or he got successful. Otherwise, he had no potentialities. He had no such worth in him. That's what the point people say. But it is absolutely wrong in estimation that you keep in mind. So one side of the picture in the sense, they don't like to see the struggle. For example, a great painting is shown to you, for example. And we try to find out what went wrong in the painting. But we don't want to understand that how many days that the painter had struggled over, how many times he maybe changed his ideas, and how many color combinations he might be used, and how many days he might have his painting of perfect or perfection and all. We don't want to see that. Only a minute or two we see as we are experts in the field, and then we comment. But that's not always fine. This is naturally the right field of the people. We do nothing about that. Next one. He must have been at the right place at the right time. Even people talk about he is now successful because at that time he was at the right place. Maybe there is no other second option for success. So that is why success may be choosing him as a final option. Maybe people comment over there. Even more, he has been at the right place at the right time. He was that time he was there, that is why he got successful. Otherwise, he has no such a potential. His people strongly believe it. See, being at the right place, being at the right time always will not help us to become successful. That means, for example, if you just imagine, if you write UPSC examination, you will become IAS officer, for example. Do you think all people who are attempting this UPSC examinations are becoming IAS officers? No, no. So this is how this. So people even talk about he may be there at the right time, at the right place, and even English literature was also little bit liberal. People start commenting on, but all these are trash. Even some people, they wanted to cover their failures. They don't want to say that they are incapable. So that is why they blame the successful persons. So that is how this line that goes. Here in this regard, I would like to give you a small example. How do people generally underestimate or misunderstand others? Whenever we talk about one person's life, then I think these lines will get fulfilled, right? Today I would like to give you an example of Soichiro Honda. Soichiro Honda from Japan, and he was not born with the proverbial English, like, you know, so born in, with silver spoon, born with the golden spoon in his mouth. Never. He was not even born in the middle class family. He was born in a very, very poor family where they have been under his poverty line. They have been facing a lot of obstacles to make him get educated. And after being had some education, and he, by his own interest, he went to nearby engineering school, and then he started finding one prototype piston rings that are used for the cars. So he went to the particular and then he made his prototype piston rings, and he went to Toyota car company. We know very well Toyota is from Japan origin, and he went to that company and presented this particular model of prototype piston rings. And at that time, the superior team was examined, and they told that this will not be called as superior model. You try for something else. So again he tried, and then he tried for more perfection. And then this time when he come back and have presented, and then this time Toyota company officials were accepted that this will be the one of the finest production, and they also readily accepted to give some capital to establish a company or maybe factory to produce this prototype piston rings, right? So he was started making his preparations to establish his factory to make this prototype piston rings. Whenever he was almost finished with his factory, there was an earthquake in Japan. We know very well, Japan is a land of earthquakes. Maximum we find number of earthquakes. So there was an earthquake, and his factory fell to the ashes. And then that time again he started making his preparations to start building his factory again. That time Japan entered into Second World War. So whenever Japan entered into Second World War, there was a scarcity of cement short supply. So that means the cement is in short supply. So there was no cement was available that time to build his factory. But with the alternative material, he started building the factory, and it is almost being completed. And at that time, America got entered into Second World War, and they started throwing bombs on Japan, and especially with the bomber planes. So they even dropped one of them, and then on the factory of Soichiro Honda, and that again went to ashes this time. So he was in complete dilemma what to do. And at that time he was identified, that time, you know, American bomber planes were using gasoline tanks, like we think very well, gases, like, you know, kerosene, petrol, we identify that they are coming in tanks like that. So maybe like a refined superior white petrol may be used there for this American bomber planes that time, that are in the this drums like a thing. So these gasoline tanks were used by these bomber planes and were thrown that particular empty this gasoline tanks. So all the ground was front with this gasoline tanks. So that time Soichiro Honda thought, why don't we use this one to build a factory? So then he used this gasoline tanks, and he was also thanked that time the President Truman, America, for giving him a gift of this gasoline tanks to build his factory. So whenever his factory was almost being done successful, and this time Japan lost war in the Second World War, and then there was very little supply available, this diesel, petrol and so on. So that means oil supply is very short, so to run the factory or vehicles and all. And that time he built a factory with the gasoline tanks, and he was ready to produce this prototype piston rings to supply to the Toyota company. So whenever he went and met them, and they were told, and you see, there was no petrol, diesel available in country, and then even the vehicles that are there also had no petrol. So if you produce also, of what use? So we are not producing temporarily, you are suspended, we are suspending this production, you can wait for some more time. So this was now becoming completely a great failure for him, but he was not such a man that easily give up. So then what then? So he was now thinking, waiting for the another word from the Toyota. And one day he was riding his bicycle. Sometimes people early morning they'll go for a walk and run, but he used to go for Once he was riding a bicycle early morning, there was a brain wave in his mind and thought, and then why don't he add a motor to his cycle? So then what else? He went, came back home and he arranged one motor and he started riding that one in his surroundings. And the neighbors and others were identified it, and they were even asked this Soichiro Honda to prepare some of them for them. So he was also prepared same for them and given, and then that time he was now thought of some marketable idea. So why don't he sell it? So that's what he thought. But he wanted some materials which are generally required to make bicycles and all. So that parts he wanted to use it to make this particular motor cycle, right? So a motor is affixed to the cycle so that without effort it will keep running, right? So that time he has selected nearly 5000 stockists of cycle companies in Japan. He has written, handwritten for them, these 5000 of them, requesting them to supply some material so that he can repay back later. So that time what else? Even 5000 he has written, but only 1800 were responded and they are ready to supply some material to him. So with the material that he received, he made one maybe one motorcycle, and then that is little bit bigger in size, and he released it, and that was utter flap, and first time it was a great failure. So he had no option to him. And then this time, after identifying his failures, and then this time again he made another model with the lightweight, and that was he named as a super cup, and that was immediate success. So there was no looking back after that to Soichiro Honda. And then there were some lakhs of employees who were employed in this factory to work in the different types of divisions in the motorcycle production. So now we can identify in the world that Soichiro Honda's establishment, Honda, is now leading even in the automobile company, you know, almost in jet speed. So even the trustable automobile is also this particular Honda is. Really. So whenever you talk about the man with the success, and we never talk about this all the failure track. A person without failure track has not been seen on the earth that he was successful. So keep this one in the mind, my dear friends. And whenever we are meeting in the next session, we'll see the one more example of Abraham Lincoln and with a more detailed account. Thank you very much, children. You keep practicing your cursive handwriting and keep reading the textbook more thoroughly to have a proper content in your mind. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next video.